Hey guys, how are you? I hope my camera is. Let's wait for someone to come live. Maybe. Aja. We are telling your followers that you have started a live video. Hang on, we are telling more followers to join. Okay, Instagram. Please call all the people to join me. So, welcome all, one and all, to my Instagram. And today's live is all about my last live in 2019. So before you say anything, I have not posted any vlog on today because I was so busy partying. But yeah, I'm going to post some of them in like this week, probably not on Sunday, but yeah, any random day. So I have made a list of what I learned in 2019. So I'm going to talk about 9 things which I learned in 2019. So I'm going to start with the first thing. I'm going to start with the first thing. The first thing which I learned in 2019, which is really important for everyone. I think so. This is something everyone should learn, is to be happy. I know it's a bit really hard to be happy all the time. But yeah, being happy is something which can drive everything. This is what I feel. Being happy is such a positive vibe that even if you have something going in your subconscious mind, it will make each and everything positive. So this is really very important, to be happy, because even if you're hustling with some of the issues or going through a rough time, but being happy will make you more confident and will give you that inspiration to face the hustle itself. So I think that being happy is one of the most important thing which I learned, and you should also try to be happy for the maximum times. But for my secret mantra of being happy is I read lots of books. Like I have read like more than 7 to 8 books in past 4 months, and then I'm practicing meditation, practicing good music. I'm like a big music and a dance fan, so yeah, I love to do this. So this is what makes me happy, and I always feel that for being happy, one should do what they like. That maybe it may be a small thing like drawing or just talking to someone. If that makes you happy, do it. Don't think. Don't overthink. And moving on to the next, being happy. And as I'm living 2 years by myself in Canada, leaving my back home, leaving my parents over there, so the second most important thing which I learned is to be independent. Independent not in the sense of like financially, or not in the sense of doing your household work, but independent something which comes from your soul, something which is like there is a sense of maturity, there is a sense of what we can say, being an understanding person. And basically it's all about the journey of being human, because nowadays we are like going mature and doing things, but yeah, sometimes you're not that independent. Especially I would like to say one short story of one of my friend. So he landed 1 year after, like 1 year before, past 1 year. And then he was living with his friends on the shared basis. But due to this, he was not able to cook or not able to do some kind of things which are really necessary for your living, and which made him really dependent upon his housemates or the roommates with whom he was sharing the rooms. And when there was a time that he has to leave that house or he has to leave that environment, he collapsed. Like, he couldn't get over that situation of being an independent, because somewhere or the other things was scrambling in his mind, and he was not able to cope up with that. Even if they forget about the daily basic things, but in like there, when you're being dependent, there is all the game of your mindset. You're not having the mindset of trying new things. You don't have that mindset of being out of your comfort zone. You're not ready to try new things. You feel everything is risky, and that all demotivates yourself, which I don't think so is a good part for being yourself, where you have to do all your things and be sorted in your life, especially when there is a stage of you have to handle all the responsibilities. So yeah, I think so, like, this is like really important, being independent, like, from your mind. Like, this, you have to set your mindset for certain things. You have to. You can't depend on each and everything for someone else to do it. Why to depend on some things to do for you? You have to take your responsibility of your things. You have to take the ownership of what you're doing, even if it's a failure. Talking about the next thing that is coming in my list is, you have to set your mindset that you can mold your failures as well. This is the third thing I learned from the second incident, from being independent, because then there are sort of things which can make you face failures. But yeah, then the failures, you have to think of to mold your failures, that even if you fail, you should not giving up before, even if you try. That is like, it doesn't make sense. You have to try. If there's something which is not getting possible or not getting into its way, you have to try to get it. One or the other day, it's going to be there. And this is what my third and fourth point is about: molding your failure and not giving up. Moving on to the next point, which I learned, is planning. And planning came when YouTube came into my life. So YouTube, I had dreamed of YouTube more than 2 years, but some other reason I was not able to cope up with the YouTube culture and how to create videos and how to edit it. In this process of learning and becoming a YouTube, I learned hell lot of things. I'm seriously grateful for that moment when I became a YouTuber, which was my long term dream. But still, I'm not a YouTuber, I'm just progressing it. So yeah, so this is what being a YouTuber, it made me hustle between my personal life and the life of my dreams or my passion. It's really hard for doing something else out of the box when you think, okay, it's going to be easy. It's never that easy. If it could have been easy, everyone could have done it. But that's not the case. When you try the things which you have never tried off, you learn a lot. When you have the learning attitude, I think so, there's nothing impossible. Everything turns out to be possible. But in this, what I learned is planning. Planning is really important, because I always run out of ideas when it's the Sunday vlog or when I'm traveling somewhere. And I'm really grateful that I started it since long, but I started it doing on a continuous basis after August, which let me develop so much even on my personal grounds. So yeah, this is what the planning essentially made me really strong, to plan things beforehand, that okay, if this is gonna happen in this week, I'm going to post this content. Then planning about my personal work, if I'm working, so planning my work schedule, planning my YouTube schedule. It made me learn so many things, even in the day-to-day life. And I think so, that's the great thing that happened to me when YouTube came into my life. So thank you, and thank you to all my supporters. Moving on to the next point, which is the sixth point. I will combine both of the points together, that is making positive friends and selfishness. So these are two points which I learned. Now how I'm going to relate that, I'm going to say about like having positive friends is really something you need. Having positive friends makes so much more about your life, because even if there is a one person who supports you or who is concerned about you or who has that willingness about you, that okay, you can do this, if your friend says this, even if you're not capable of doing it, you will do it. And this is the power of positiveness, the power of support, the power of belief in you. So having your friend circle as a good positive friends and not being jealous, oh you're doing this and why you're doing this, it's not good, it takes time, just eliminate those kind of vibes and those kind of people from your list, because I feel that it's so much important to be in the positive group and be in the good group where people are really so helpful and so supportive. And I can hardly count like four people in my list who are really good friend of mine and who really have that thing that okay, you can do this. They have belief in me and even I have the same emotions for them as well. So having that feeling is really the best. So make your list of people and choice of your people very carefully, because you never know which person can hurt you and which person can betray you or which person can harm your feelings, or if you are into too much of caring and loving, even if you are friends and your sisters and your relatives and your cousins. But yeah, you have to learn about maintaining distances with all these kinds of emotions and all these kind of people. So making positive friends, good friends is really very important. And combined with this is the one thing which I want to mention, is being with a good group, also being selfish at the same time is really important. Being selfish is what I mean to say, that importance for yourself is really very important, because sometimes people tend to do the things out of the box for you, like even you can do for them, living your self-importance. Because sometimes it happens that, the simple example I would like to give in this is, if you are having a meeting with your friend and due to not so genuine reason he is late by 2 hours and you're sitting somewhere in the park waiting for her or him, so this doesn't make any sense. You're wasting 2 hours of your life without any clue, and you never know that 2 hours, but when your time comes, when there is your time, if you're being late or running late, I don't think so the situation will be more or less the same with the same friend itself. So this kind of things may happen. So this is the reason I want to focus on being selfishness, that self-importance is the most important thing which we should learn at. Valuing ourselves is so important. So please do value your worth and make good friends, positive friends. So turning on to my next point is having the moral values. This is the 8th point which I would like to mention. And turning out to the moral values, I mean to say, nowadays it's so much of social media influence and so much about being on Facebook, being on Instagram, being on WhatsApp or being on any other social media platform where even a small thing can be noticed by many of them. But yeah, I feel so somewhere or the other, this is hurting a lot of people, because people are making this social media a negligible part of their day, in which they are always 24/7 on WhatsApp or on Facebook and not doing any productive kind of thing, which itself is leading them to laziness or more dependable or like having impatience to see the message inbox now and then. So this kind of things are growing day by day, and I don't think so this is having a good influence as being a human, because when there is such kind of things, there are so many things. I would like to say that there have been fights in the groups. I can relate. Everyone I can see watching can relate to this. There are fights on WhatsApp group like hell. If there's someone friend of yours is messaging something about, she said like that and she said like this, and there is a fight among the group, then people exit the group, and then there's a whole lot of chaos. Then you waste your time calling up what happened, and the person is hanging up. There's so lot of chaos. So it's better you call up and say what you want to do instead of just message, because texting is something really out of the box. It can give you wrong messages, even if you're not that way, if you doesn't sound in that way. But yeah, it can lead to deliver the wrong messages, which I think so no one wants to do that. So please make that human connection with each other. Try to talk, try to understand each other, even if you're closest group, at least in a day. This is what I have been practicing since 4 months, that in a day I call at least 2 or 3 friends of mine to know about how it's going, are they okay, or what's the current status, and to share new things or to learn new things if they are trying on something or if they are good at something. Then I like to learn that, and to know about some of the information if they are visiting some places or doing something extraordinary, which I don't do on the regular basis. So doing this is making that connectivity as well and having that support as well. So yeah, and I like to travel a lot. So each day I travel, there is always 1 or 2 people to which I have that communication and connection, and then we exchange our numbers. It's all about strange meetings. It's like I would talk about the recent incident itself. I was visiting some of the places for vlogging, so I was visiting some other city in Toronto itself, and I was talking to the public transport driver, and we were talking like till I get onto the bus, till I get off, and he was so kind and so polite that you have that positive vibes when talking to the people, discussing about some issues, even if that's bullshit. But when you talk, you feel that connectivity and you feel happy. Okay, there's so many of people who like to connect, and there's so many things. You just try on to talk to one stranger each day and see how it goes. See, first day you will feel, second day you will feel, third day you will feel, but yeah, eventually you will learn. You will learn the skill of communication, which I think is really important and useful to each and everyone in each and every field, in each and every whatever you can say. But communication is the key. If you can make anyone understand or influence about your talk, I think so that's the great thing which you can do. Even if like talking to someone can make you happy, so this is what makes me happy. You can try that. So eventually or not, you may learn the things and you can be happy yourself. So this is the thing which I want to mention as the 8th thing, and the most important thing which I learned about my moral values, that I really cannot negotiate on being dishonest, lies, and dishonest and lies, which I really can't digest, is something which I really look forward for the people. And I say that, see, if you want to be my really good friend for a long time, these 2 things should be eliminated from your list. Otherwise, you are going to see the bad side of me. And I think so every person agrees with it, because these are the things which are the moral values you have, and you want to be, which will gain trust in the other people who are standing with you. So I think, yeah, this values carries a lot of importance. And last but not the least, the major thing which I learned, and I'm really happy to say, is to master your mind. So what it is about mastering your mind is to train your mind in such a way that you are the owner of your mind. So whatever thought comes in, it may be positive, negative, you are only the owner of your mindset. If you set your mindset in a positive goal, it will attract positivity. If you set your mind in the negative goal, it will attract negativity. Just try it to control your mindset. Like I tried this in n number of things, and to be honest, it started with books which I started reading, and one of the books which I really mentioned is The Doer Mindset, which is launched by one of my friend. That book is really awesome. It's really awesome. It tells you about how to do things, how to observe the things, how to execute it, and how to repeat it. Because if the things are not repeated, that means you are not progressing. You are doing, you are observing, you are executing, and then repeating it. It's so powerful book that I think so it bought so much of my change in my mindset. So mindset is the key. Mindset is the key, guys. Mindset is the key. Whatever vibes you set in your mind are going to be there with you. So I always say to the people, having a right mindset is so much important. And this leads to that this is something that you should be keeping in your mind, that while selecting some of your new friends or some talking to someone else, then what kind of mindset he has. Does he has the growth mindset? Does he has the mindset of being jealous? Does he or she has that mindset of not being independent, dependent, using someone else for your work? Or there are so many things. So this kind of behaviors and this kind of what you can say, this kind of like behavior and all circumstances, you can observe while you're making friends. So this is one important tip I can give you. Choose your friends wisely, depending upon observing how and what mindset they have, because mindset is something that passes the positive vibe from one person to another. If you're meeting the right person, I'm emphasizing it 1,000 times. So this is what I learned in 2019 in my 9 things. And I hope you like my video. And thank you everyone for joining me. There is Nihan, Priyanka, then there was Shivraj, and there was Shukiran, Mayur. So many of you joined me, and I'm really sorry I couldn't say hi to you. So Serialized, Varun joined me. Thank you so much for joining my live section of 2019. And I will be rocking in 2020, and let's get started with 2020 very, very, very soon. And with this, I wish you a happy, happy new year to all of you. Lots of love from Exploring Life, and stay tuned to my YouTube channel. Please share with your friend, guys. Please be that supporting friend of mine, and support me in my next YouTube journey in 2020. Hope to see you soon, and wish you a very, very happy new year. And please do comment in the box, how did you like my 9 things which I learned, and which was the most important thing you would like to take it as a practice in 2020. And I would like to read them and just pass on some message if I have, and we can share some of our experience as well. You can connect with me on Instagram. I'm like, most time I'm like available 24/7. I can see that because there's so many people messaging me, and there's not even a single person whom I don't reply, because I'm very much active in on Instagram. So even my WhatsApp people join me on Instagram. So this is how I'm connected to people over Instagram, even with my followers, even my subscribers. And lots of love to everyone, and wish you a happy new year to you and your family. Bye bye.